Welcome to this video lecture, and today lecture we will discuss about the adenoviridae family. First we will discuss about the general thinking of the adenoviruses. So first one is the word adenovirus. Word adenovirus come from the Greek word that is the adenos, and the meaning of the adenos is the glands. The adenovirus first isolated from the Spain distribution is the worldwide. Most of country animals and birds are affected with the adenovirus, and adenovirus mainly in fact the canine species and birds, some of canine species and some species of birds, and they mainly causes disease related to the respiratory system and systemic disease causes by the adenovirus. Then the adenovirus is the DNA virus, and they have the liner, single liner double stranded DNA as a genetic material. Because of it is a DNA virus, it replicate in the cell nucleus and it produce the intranuclear basophilic inclusion body in the nucleus of the cell. Then we will discuss about the detail about the adenoviridae family. Then we will discuss about the adenoviridae family. First one is the general characteristics or general characteristic feature of the adenovirus. So first one is the symmetry of the adenovirus is the icosahedral, and the diameter of the virus is the 70 to 90 nanometer. So the adenovirus have the icosahedral symmetry and diameter is the 70 to 90 nanometer. Next point, the adenovirus is the non-enveloped virus, and they have the double stranded DNA virus, means they have the genetic material is the double stranded DNA. This is the single stranded and this is the double stranded DNA. So they have the double stranded DNA virus. Because of the have the DNA virus, they replicate in the nucleus of the cells, and they produce the or they forming the intranuclear inclusion body, and the nature of the inclusion body is the basophilic, and the inclusion body is found in the stem tissue section of the affected animals. So the adenovirus is the double stranded DNA virus, and they replicate in the nucleus of the cells and forming the intranuclear basophilic inclusion body in stem tissue section. Next point, they are the adenovirus are the moderately stable in the environment, means they are generally stable in the normal environmental conditions, and the distributed is distribution of the adenovirus is the worldwide. Next point, they produce the systemic and respiratory disease in dogs. The adenovirus produce the systemic and respiratory disease in dogs and systemic disease in poultry. Mainly the pathogenic strain of the adenovirus mainly affect the dogs and poultry. Mainly affect the dog and poultry. Then the classification of the adenovirus. In classification of the adenovirus, they have the four genera. Adenovirus have the four genera. First one is the AV adenovirus. First one is the AV adenovirus. Second one is the mastoidinovirus. Third one is the ETA adenovirus. ET adenovirus, and last one is the C adenovirus. So AV adenovirus, in fact the avian species or also called as or include the avian adenovirus. In AV adenovirus include the avian adenoviruses, they infect the avian species.
नेक्स्ट वन इज द मेस्ट एडिनो वायरस. दे इनफैक्ट और दे इंक्लूड द मेमेलियन एडिनो वायरस एंड दे इनफैक्ट द मेमेलियन स्पीसीज. नेक्स्ट वन इज द ऑटो एडिनो वायरस, द वायरस ऑफ द वर्टिब्रेट्स. एंड सी एडिनो वायरस, एम्फीबियन वायरस एंड एवियन वायरस. देन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द एडिनोवायरस फैमिली एंड द विच जीनस इनफैक्ट द विच स्पीसीज और इंक्लूड द विच स्ट्रेन ऑफ द वेरियस डोमेस्टिक एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स. सो फर्स्ट वन इज द फैमिली इज द एडिनोवायरिडाइ. इन एडिनोवायरिडाइ वी इंक्लूड द फोर जीनस. फर्स्ट इन मेस्ट एडिनोवायरस. इन मेस्ट एडिनोवायरस विच स्पीसीज और विच स्ट्रेन ऑफ द वायरस दे इनफैक्ट द डोमेस्टिक एनिमल्स. दैट इज द फर्स्ट वन इज द बोवाइन एडिनोवायरस ए बी सी. सो दीज आर द थ्री स्ट्रेन ऑफ द बोवाइन, दैट इज द बोवाइन एडिनोवायरस ए, बोवाइन एडिनोवायरस बी एंड बोवाइन एडिनोवायरस सी. नेक्स्ट वन इज द केनाइन एडिनो वायरस. थर्ड वन इज द इक्वाइन एडिनो वायरस ए एंड बी. फोर्थ वन इज द ओवाइन एडिनो वायरस ए एंड बी. लास्ट वन इज द पोर्सिन एडिनो वायरस ए बी एंड सी. नेक्स्ट जीनस दैट इज द एवी एडिनो वायरस. इन एवी एडिनो वायरस दे इनफैक्ट द बर्ड्स स्पीसीज इंक्लूड द फाउल एडिनो वायरस ए बी सी डी ई. दीज आर द फाइव स्ट्रेन ऑफ द फाउल एडिनो वायरस. दे आर द ए बी सी डी एंड ई. नेक्स्ट वन इज द गूस एडिनो वायरस. नेक्स्ट जीनस That is the adenovirus. Adenovirus have three species: bovine adenovirus D, ovine adenovirus D, or duck adenovirus A. Next genus that is the C adenovirus. They include the two species, that is the frog adenovirus and turkey adenovirus A. So this is the simple classification of the adenoviridae family. Then the clinical infection of the adenovirus. So adenovirus infection can be partially severe in the dogs and domestic fowls. Generally the adenovirus infection causes severe infection in the dogs and domestic fowls only. In other animals, they not causes a severe type of the infection. Next point, two serotype of the canine adenovirus are recognized. First one is the infection with the canine adenovirus type first. Two serotype of the canine adenovirus, that is the canine adenovirus type first and the canine adenovirus type second. The canine adenovirus type first, CAV, first causes infectious canine hepatitis. Causes infectious canine hepatitis, a severe generalized disease. So, canine adenovirus type first causes infectious canine hepatitis in canine species and serotype second, that is the canine adenovirus type second, CAV second, is commonly associated with the localized respiratory disease. Localized respiratory disease. If a canine species affected or associated with the respiratory symptoms, so these are causes by the canine adenovirus type second, and if they causes the hepatic infection or other generalized diseases, so these causes by the canine adenovirus type first. In domestic mammals, the adenovirus may causes the enteric and respiratory problems. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इन एवियन एडिनोवायरस, एवियन एडिनोवायरस आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड वर्ल्ड वाइड. एवियन एडिनोवायरस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज वर्ल्ड वाइड, मीन्स मोस्ट ऑफ कंट्री बर्ड्स आर अफेक्टेड विद द एवियन एडिनोवायरस एंड हैव बीन आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम ए वाइड रेंज ऑफ द स्पीसीज. वाइड रेंज ऑफ द स्पीसीज आर अफेक्टेड विद द एवियन एडिनोवायरस इंक्लूडिंग द चिकन, टर्की, पेंथेंस, पिजन्स, डक, क्विल, गीज, गुनिया फाउल्स एंड बुड गैरीज. So most of the or wide range of the wide range of species of the birds are affected with the avian adenovirus. Next one is the infectious canine hepatitis. First disease that causes by the canine adenovirus type. First is the infectious canine hepatitis. The infectious canine hepatitis is a disease of the canine species. Just include the dogs and the cat, but dogs are mainly affected with the infectious canine hepatitis. The infectious canine hepatitis is caused by the CAV first. CAV means canine adenovirus type first virus. Next point. This is the worldwide distribution of the canine adenovirus type first virus. So the disease of the disease that is the infectious canine hepatitis is the worldwide and generalized viral disease of dogs. This is the generalized viral disease of the dogs affect the liver and vesicular endothelium. The canine adenovirus type first mainly affect the liver of the dog species and vesicular endothelium. Next one is the pathogenesis. Firstly, the ingestion of the virus and the canine adenovirus type first localized in the tonsil and Peyer's patches. Mainly the entry of the virus through the respiratory tract. Mainly, maybe the oral cavity is also a route of the entrance of the virus. But mainly the route of the entry of the virus is the respiratory system. So after the ingestion or inhalation of the virus that is the canine adenovirus first is localized in the tonsil and the Peyer's patches of the canine species. Next point, replication in the vascular endothelium result in the rapid distribution of the virus throughout the body. After the localization in the Peyer's tonsil and Peyer's patches, the virus also enter in the vascular endothelium, and the replication in the vascular endothelium, rapid replication in the vascular endothelium, and the rapid distribution of the virus throughout the body. If the virus distributed throughout the body, so the condition is called the viremia. If the virus enter or distributed throughout the body is called as the viremia. So viremia is developed. Next point, virus replication also occurs in the parenchymal cells of the liver and kidney. Mainly the virus replicate in the tonsil, Peyer's patches and vascular endothelium. Tonsil, Peyer's patches and vascular endothelium. But virus may also replicate in the parenchymal cells of the liver and kidney. So this is the overview of the canine adenovirus first. So first one is the ingestion of the virus. First one is the ingestion or inhalation of the virus. Then the local replication in the tonsil and pair spaces. First one is the first one replicate in the tonsil and pair spaces. Then the distribution of the virus throughout the body. So the condition is called as the viremia. If the virus present all body organs and all body parts, so this condition is called viremia. So after the viremia, they produced two things. First one is the they produce the cytopathic effect due to the viral replication. They produce the cytopathic effects due to the viral replication on the replicating site. So first one is the hepatocytes. First replication site, that is the hepatocyte. Acute hepatitis, if the enter in the hepatocytes, they causes the acute hepatitis, inflammation of the liver, intranuclear inclusion body also present at the site. Next thing, that is the renal tubule cells. That is the renal tubule cells. In renal tubule cells, they produce the nephritis and virus shed in the urine. If they enter in the renal tubules, so they causes the nephritis and virus also shed in the urine. Third thing, vascular endothelial cells. If the virus enter in the vascular endothelial cells, so they produce the hemorrhages and DIC, intranuclear inclusion body also found. They produced hemorrhages at various sites. So if the viremia that produced some of the cytopathic effect, that is the in hepatocytes, renal tubules and vascular endothelial cells. Second thing, that is the antibody production. Second thing, that is the antibody production. In antibody production, immune complex formation. If the virus enter in the animal body and some of animal body and they act as a antigen and against antigen or body produced the antibody, and if these antigen antibody are interact and they form the form a complex, they called as the immune complex. So if the antibody production is occurred, so they produce the immune complex. So if they produce the immune complex, they also found the two possibilities or two things. First one is the, if the immune complex circulating the immune complex, if this immune complex is circulate in our body by the blood, so deposition in the renal glomeruli. One thing, that is these immune complex circulate in the circulate through the blood and they deposit in the renal glomeruli and they produce the glomerulonephritis. They produced glomerulonephritis. In other thing, they local immune complex formation. This is the generalized immune. This is the generalized immune complex and other form, that is the local immune complex formation. In the local immune complex formation, corneal edema and opacity, anterior uveitis. So in this condition, the complex are deposit in the eye and they produce the corneal edema and opacity, anterior uveitis, means inflammation of the iris. And in this condition, the eye look like in the blue color. So this is also called as the blue eye disease. The clinical sign of the infectious canine hepatitis. The incubation period of the disease is up to 7 days. Incubation period is up to 7 days. Next point, Dogs of all ages are susceptible. All age groups of the dogs are susceptible, and most of all species of the dogs are susceptible with the infectious canine hepatitis. Next point, subclinical infection is common. They show the severe infection and show the severe symptom suddenly. Next point, mortality rate ranges from 10 to 30% is the mortality rate, means death rate in mature dogs, and up to 100% in the young pups. If the young pups are affected with the infectious canine hepatitis and canine adenovirus type first, so 100% they are die. And if the mature dog are affected with this disease, so the mortality rate is up to 10 to 30%. In per acute disease, death occurs so rapidly. If the per acute condition means the disease symptoms show suddenly and surprised, so the death of the animals are surprisingly. Second point, in acute disease, affected dog present with fever, depression, anorexia, increased thirst, vomiting and diarrhea. So some of other things are also seen in some other diseases like the fever, depression, anorexia, but the vomiting and diarrhea most commonly seen in the infectious canine hepatitis, and diarrhea or vomiting color may be in greenish in color. Next point, abdominal palpation may be elicit pain. If we palpate the abdomen of the animal, so this is elicit the pain of the animal. Next point, corneal opacity, either unilateral or bilateral. Corneal opacity may show the unilateral, means one eye, or bilateral, means both eye, may occurs within week. Corneal opacity may occurs within a week of the clinical recovered. Clinical recovery is in about 20% of affected animals. If corneal opacity seen, so these corneal opacity is recovered 20% of the affected animals. Next point, recovered animal have lifelong immunity. Recovered animal with the infectious canine hepatitis, they have the lifelong immunity. Then the diagnosis. In diagnosis, a history of the fever, sudden collapse and abdominal pain in the young unvaccinated dogs may suggest infectious canine hepatitis. So history is show the important criteria for the diagnosis or identification of a particular infection. So history of the fever, sudden collapse and abdominal pain, this is the important thing, that is the abdominal pain in young animals, especially in the abdominal pain show especially in the young animal and unvaccinated dogs. Vaccination against the adenovirus available in market, so if the unvaccinated dogs are show these symptoms, so maybe they infected with the infectious canine hepatitis disease or the virus, that is the canine adenovirus type first. Next diagnostic technique that used for the diagnosis of the canine adenovirus type first, that is the hematological examination, may reveal the marked reduction in the neutrophils and lymphocyte during the febrile stage. In febrile stage, the hematological examination also helpful for the diagnosis of the infectious canine hepatitis. That is the mark reduction of the neutrophils and lymphocytes. Next point, the affected animal clotting time, blood of the affected animal clotting time may be prolonged, means clotting time of these animals blood is increased. Next technique, that is the basophilic intranuclear inclusion body in the hepatocytes, Kupffer cells and endothelial cells are confirmatory. So if the confirmatory diagnosis of the adenovirus that are helpful, that is the identification of the basophilic intranuclear inclusion body in the hepatocytes, Kupffer cells and endothelial cells. Next diagnostic technique we can use in the infectious canine hepatitis, that is the viral antigen can be demonstrated by the immunofluorescence in the cryostate sections of the liver. So immunofluorescence also used in the demonstration of the viral antigen. Next method used, that is the PCR, that is polymerase chain reaction, for the detecting the viral DNA in the clinical specimens. Next one is the clinical specimen does just include the urine if the virus infect the urinary system. Next point, suitable specimen for the virus isolation in the canine kidney if the animal are die canine kidney cells, including oropharyngeal swab, blood, urine and feces from the affected animal sample. If the animal are die, so we can use the kidney cells, but if the animal are live, so we can take the urine, blood and feces of the affected animal. Then next disease, that is the infection with the canine adenovirus type 2. So these virus, that is the canine adenovirus type 2, that is transmitted by the aerosol. These virus transmitted by the aerosols replicate in both of the upper and lower respiratory tract. These virus replicate in the both in the upper and lower respiratory tract. The clinical signs are generally mild. They not produce the severe clinical signs just like the canine adenovirus type 1. They produce only mild clinical symptoms or clinical signs. Clinical sign include the canal cough. Some of the animals or some of the canine species affected with the canine adenovirus type 2, they produce or they affected with the canal cough. They produced continuously coughing. They called as the canal cough. Next point, most dog recovered and or immune to subsequent challenge. So most of animal, they are affected with the canine adenovirus type 2, they are recovered and they are immune to subsequent challenge. They are immune to next infection or further infection. Bronchopneumonia may develop due to the secondary bacterial infection. Maybe bronchopneumonia is seen in the canine adenovirus type 2 because of secondary bacterial infection, not by the canine adenovirus type 2, but the bronchopneumonia is developed or produced by the secondary bacterial infection. Next one is, the diagnosis can be confirmed by the virus isolation, in situ hybridization and PCR. The canine adenovirus type 2 is diagnosed, confirmatory diagnosis, by the virus isolation or in situ hybridization and PCR technique. नेक्स्ट वन इज द डिजीज ऑफ द बर्ड्स caused by the adenovirus. Some of the birds, the disease that causes by the adenovirus that are the first disease is the hydropericardium syndrome. Hydropericardium syndrome, that is the angora disease. This is important. This is important. Second one is the egg drop syndrome. This is also important. And third one is the turkey adenovirus. Third, that is also called as the hemorrhagic enteritis of the turkey. Last one is the quill bronchitis. So these are the four important disease in the birds that causes by the adenovirus. First one is the hydropericardium syndrome or angora disease. This is the disease of the avian species. So then the discussed about that disease. So first point is the disease associated with the infection of the genus AV adenovirus, but most severe manifestation of the disease required the co-infection with the immunosuppressive agent or the exposed with the immunosuppressive aflatoxin. Mainly the disease associated with the infection of the AV adenovirus, genus of the member of the genus AV adenovirus, but these severe infection of the AV adenovirus is associated with some of the other things, just like the immunosuppressive, some of the immunosuppressive agents, or some of the birds are affected or exposed to immunosuppressive agents just like the aflatoxin. So if these immunosuppressive exposure with those birds, they are also severe infection of the AV adenovirus. Mortality rate of the AV adenovirus is the 20 to 80% in birds. Next point, the disease causes in birds at 3 week of the age and peaking at 4 to 5 week in meat chicks. Generally the 3 week of birds, 3 week age of the birds are mostly affected, but the chicken meat or meat chickens are mainly affected 4 to 5 week also. Next point, milder disease can occur in the older chickens such as breeders and layers. The milder disease can seen in the breeders and layers also. The symptoms include that is the affected birds exhibited to pericardial effusions, pulmonary edema, hepatomegaly and enlarged kidney. So these are main symptoms that found with the hydropericardium, that is the pericymal effusion mainly found. Next one is the pulmonary edema also present and hepatomegaly, increase the liver size and enlarged kidney also found in the hydropericardium. Next one is the diagnosis. The disease is not diagnosed only on the basis of the clinical symptoms. So diagnostic technique like the virus neutralization and fluorescent antibody test also used because of the various symptoms correlated with other disease, just like the increase in size of the liver, kidney, they are also found in many disease. So these clinical symptoms are or lesions are correlated with other disease. So the diagnostic techniques we used for the adenovirus identification, we use the virus neutralization test or fluorescent antibody test also. Next point, virus isolation done in the chicken embryo liver cells and chicken embryo kidney cells. Virus isolation is done on the chicken embryo liver cell and chicken embryo kidney cell culture. ओके नेक्स्ट वन इज द सीरम एंटीबॉडीज कैन बी डिटेक्टेड बाय द जेल डिफ्यूजन और बाय द वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन टेस्ट. द सीरम एंटीबॉडी आल्सो डिटेक्टेड बाय द टू टेस्ट यूज दैट इज द जेल डिफ्यूजन और वायरस न्यूट्रलाइजेशन टेस्ट. दीज आर द सीरोलॉजिकल टेस्ट. सो दीज टेस्ट आर आल्सो यूज फॉर द डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द एवी एडिनो वायरस इन्फेक्शन. एवी एडिनो वायरस इन्फेक्शन. नेक्स्ट डिजीज इन द बर्ड्स दैट इज द एग ड्रॉप सिंड्रोम. दिस इज ऑल्सो ए इम्पोर्टेंट डिजीज इन बर्ड्स. सो इट द डिजीज हैज बीन रिकोगनाइज इन द चिकन्स एंड बोथ ऑफ द डोमेस्टिक एंड वाइल्ड डॉग्स एंड गीज ऑल्सो. द एग ड्रॉप सिंड्रोम्स मेनली रिकोगनाइज इन द चिकन्स एंड ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड विद द डोमेस्टिक एंड वाइल्ड डॉग्स एंड गीज. बट द चिकन्स आर द मेजर स्पीसीज अफेक्टेड बाय दिस वायरस. द चिकन्स आर मेनली अफेक्टेड स्पीसीज विद द एवी एडिनो वायरस. दिस इज द वर्ल्ड वाइड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द एग ड्रॉप सिंड्रोम्स एंड द डिजीज एसोसिएटेड विद द इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द जीनस एवी एडिनो वायरस. द एग ड्रॉप सिंड्रोम इज ऑल्सो कॉज्ड बाई द एवी एडिनो वायरस. द एग ड्रॉप सिंड्रोम डिजीज इज करेक्टराइज्ड बाई द सॉफ्ट सेल एग characterized by the soft cell egg and cell-less egg production by the apparently healthy birds. Birds are healthy but they have the soft, they produce the soft cell egg and cell-less egg. They produce the soft cell egg and cell-less egg. So this is the characteristic symptoms of the egg drop syndrome in the laying birds, only in the laying birds. Next point, also loss of color in the pigmented eggs. If some species of the chickens, they produce the pigmented eggs, and if these species they lose the color of these pigments, so this is also a characteristic symptoms of the egg drop syndrome disease. Next one is the dropped egg production started at 29 to 31 week of age, which did not return to normal. Generally, the egg drop syndrome or AV adenovirus affect in the laying birds at the 29 to 30 week of the age, and mainly this is the peak age of the egg production. If birds are affected with the egg drop syndrome or birds are affected with the AV adenovirus and they decrease the egg production, so they not return or they not come to normal production of the eggs. So this is also a characteristic feature of the egg drop syndrome, and birds are affected with the AV adenovirus. Next point, eggs were smaller and of poor cell strength. These birds, they are affected with the avian adenovirus, and these are layers especially affected with the avian adenovirus. So they produced the smaller size of the egg and poor cell strength of these eggs, and the eggs are smaller in the size. Next one is the transmission of the egg drop syndrome. Mainly the incubation period is important, that is the incubation period is mainly the 7 days. Incubation period of egg drop syndrome is the 7 days. Mainly the contaminated egg. The transmission of the egg drop syndrome or AV adenovirus is mainly by the contaminated eggs are transmit the AV adenovirus. Next point, that is the dropping of the birds also contain the virus. The dropping of these affected birds also have the virus. Next point, contaminated fomites such as the crates and trucks can spread the virus. So this is also spread the virus, also transmitted by the needle used for the vaccination. Needle can also transmit the virus that used for the vaccination. So this is the transmission of the HIV adenovirus. Mainly breeding flock were infected with the HIV adenovirus and they mainly produce the egg drop syndrome. Next, that is, virus was spread widely through the fertile egg. Mainly the virus spread through the fertile eggs. Next point, infection usually remains latent until birds reaches the sexual maturity, and because virus transmit vertically in eggs, generally the if a egg is infected and this is a egg of a bird, so they produced a bird, they produced a chick, they produced a chick, sorry, they produced a smaller chick, and after they reaches their sexually maturity, they produce their sexually maturity, and after to sexually maturity, they transmit vertically, and the symptoms of the disease are show. Symptoms of the disease are show if the birds are laying and if the birds are used in the breeding purpose or also in the mate purpose. Clinical symptoms. In clinical symptoms, the thin cell egg are the main clinical symptoms. They may have rough and even sandpaper-like surface of the egg and thin cell egg. Mainly the clinical symptoms of the egg drop syndrome. Next one is, the egg production may decreased by a maximum up to 40%. Egg production is decreased up to 40% in the egg drop syndrome. Then the lesions. This is correct, the spelling. This is the cratersticks. This is the cratersticks. The cratersticks lesions in the infected birds in the pouch cell gland and in the oviduct. Mainly the lesions found in the pouch cell gland and in the oviduct of the layer birds. Next point, where the epithelial cell become necrotic and contain the intranuclear inclusion bodies. Some of the epithelial cells these are the necrotized and they contain the intranuclear inclusion body also. Next one is the diagnosis. Diagnosis on the basis of the clinical sign and lesions. Next point, clinical sign include the egg drop of the egg production or thin cell egg and some of the weak cell, or in lesions they find the necrotic epithelial cells and intranuclear inclusion body also found. Next one, diagnostic feature, that is the diagnosis confirmed by the virus isolation and virus isolation or serological test also used for the confirmatory diagnosis. Next point, that is the hemagglutination inhibition and neutralization assay are specific for this virus. Some of the hemagglutination test and neutralization assay that used for the confirmatory diagnosis, and some of these tests that are specific for the adenovirus. Next point, the virus grow to higher liter in the embryonating egg of the duck, geese or cell culture derived from the duck, geese or chickens, especially well in the duck's kidney, duck embryo liver and duck embryo fibroblast. So these are the various cell line used for the HIV adenovirus isolation. नेक्स्ट वन इज द वैक्सीन इनएक्टिवेटेड वैक्सीन अवेलेबल इनएक्टिवेटेड वैक्सीन अवेलेबल फॉर यूज इन द चिकन्स बिफोर दे बीइंग लेइंग एग्स बिफोर दे स्टार्ट टू द लेइंग एग्स दे आर वैक्सीनेटेड एंड द वैक्सीन इज इनएक्टिवेटेड वैक्सीन दे ओनली रिड्यूस्ड रेदर देन द एलिमिनेट द वायरस ट्रांसमिशन टर्की एडिनोवायरस थर्ड दिस इज द मेनली अफेक्ट द टर्की एंड ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द हेमरेजिक एंट्राइटिस ऑफ द टर्की द टर्की एडिनोवायरस थर्ड और हेमरेजिक एंट्राइटिस ऑफ द टर्की इज कोस्ड बाय द टर्की एडिनोवायरस थर्ड caused by the turkey adenovirus third now designated turkey adenovirus a this is designated turkey adenovirus a acute infection of the turkey older than the 4 week mainly the acute infection of the turkey they are older than the 4 week of the The virus is transmitted radially by the contact or by the fomites. The virus that is radially transmitted by the contact or by the fomites. Virus stable in the contaminated dropping and litter. Next point, flock mortality may reach up to 60%. So that this is important disease and although the usual mortality is 1 to 3% may be reaches to 60% but not always is 60% always is 1 to 3% but may be reaches to 60% next one is the clinical symptoms clinically the disease has an acute onset with the depression bloody dropping and death of the birds so in the clinical symptom they not show more symptoms with the this virus so some of the clinical symptoms include the depression of the birds and bloody dropping this is a characteristic symptoms with this disease and death of the birds then the lesions are the pathognomic that is prominent macrophage phagocytic cell hyperplasia this is prominent macrophage phagocytic hyperplasia also found in this disease intranuclear inclusion body in the spleen specially intranuclear inclusion body in the spleen found and a distended bloody intestine because of bloody dropping also found next one is the pseudomembrane fibrinonecrotic inflammation in the duodenum so this disease in this disease mainly symptoms found to found related to the intestine diagnosis of infection may be confirmed by the serology using and the immunoassay or agar gel immunofluorescence mainly in the viral infection we use the serological testing for the confirmatory diagnosis and for the identification of the virus next point by virus isolation with the identification of the isolate by the immunohistochemistry immunofluorescence and PCR so also for the isolation and identification of the virus of isolate by the immunohistochemistry immunofluorescence techniques and PCR technique we can use for the confirmatory diagnosis and isolation of the virus then the vaccine for vaccination using a live attenuated virus produced either in the turkey spleen cells or in the turkey B lymphoblast cell so vaccine used by the live attenuated we use the live attenuated virus vaccine produced in the turkey spleen cell or in the turkey B lymphoblast cells. Vaccine is administered via the drinking water. Generally, the vaccine is administered by the drinking water. Optimum age of the vaccination is 4 to 5 weeks. Then the quill bronchitis, next disease, that is the quill bronchitis. It is important disease of the wild and the captive birds worldwide. So it quill bronchitis is also a worldwide disease, both of the wild and captive birds, caused by the adenovirus A. Quill bronchitis is caused by the adenovirus A. Mortality may be 100%, and young birds are mainly affected. Mortality in young birds is 100%, but falls to less than 25% in birds aged more than 4 weeks when infected. In young birds, the mortality of the quill is 100%, but less than 25% mortality in aged birds, that is, they have the more than 4 weeks of the age. Clinical symptoms. The young birds is manifested as some of the important clinical symptoms found in the young birds, that are the respiratory distress, open mouth breathing. They are breathed with open mouth, nasal discharge also present, coughing, sneezing, rales, lacrimation or conjunctivitis. So these are the main symptoms found in the quill bronchitis. So these most of are the respiratory system related symptoms. In older birds may be diarrhea also present with the respiratory symptoms. Lesions. The disease is marked by the necrotic and hemorrhagic tracheitis. Necrotic and hemorrhagic tracheitis, inflammation of the trachea, and with the inflammation or hemorrhages and necrosis. Mainly the inflammation of the trachea occurs, may be present the necrosis also occurs, and may be the hemorrhages present in the trachea with the distant large basophilic intranuclear inclusion body. The epithelial cells of the trachea also have the basophilic intranuclear inclusion body found. Multifocal hepatic necrosis is also present with the quill bronchitis and goose mucoid gaseous or mucoid enteritis is also present.